Are we good?
I think so.
Oh, shit.
Is it going down?
Em and Friends is going down.
Oh, my God.
Love and lies. All right. Ladies and gentlemen, welcome. We are launching a new segment, Love and Lies podcast, called M and Friends, where I'm chilling with a couple of my girlies and one lucky male.
Hey!
There will be a special male guest for each segment as we go over random debates and give life and love advice to our friends listening.
Say hi, everybody.
What's up?
What's up?
Hey, friends.
I'm super excited about this. You guys, I've talked about this for such a long time, and now it's come to full fruition, and it's been like a little passion project, and we're all here, and this is our reality right now, so it's really cool.
Yes.
All right, so today with me is Mel.
Hi,
I always refer to you as my badass, but all my girlfriends are badasses, but you really chew up. You are a badass. Oh, you also you do video games for like Vegas, mm-hmm. right? Design.
Yep.
So what are the chances are? I know. What are the chances are when somebody's in Vegas that they're playing a slot machine or something like that, that you had something to do with it?
Pretty good chance. I've been in gaming for 20 years. So yeah, we've been designing those slot machine games for a long time, and good chance if you sit down and play a slot, I've had something to do with that one.
That is so dope.
Are there any tricks to winning?
Yeah, why are we sitting here, right? Why are you not rigging up machines and getting all the money?
No, there's no trick to winning. It's just all luck.
There's one slot machine, remember, babe, that I remember when we were in Vegas, and I thought, I swear to God, I was going to win, and I just, all my money kept on going into it. I swear, when I go back, I'm going back to that slot machine.
You wouldn't walk away from it.
I would not walk away from it. Also with me is Brittney.
Hi.
Brittney is my personal trainer and another badass, and you inspire a lot of women out there for fitness and nutrition, even myself. You and I met, you were a customer, you came into the Platinum Spray Tan, and we totally hit it off. Melanie, you and I met that
You're
way
also.
Too.
Mm-hmm.
But then one day I moved into a house, and then one day I was pulling out of my driveway, and you were literally in the driveway right next to me. And I'm like, is that that girl?
On the other side of town too.
On the other side of town. So we both, we moved in right next to each other. She was the house right next to me.
Yeah.
What are the chances?
That was so fucking crazy.
In Vegas odds that purely not a chance.
And then now we also have Ricky the Dragon, champion fighter, my MMA trainer, and also my man. Maybe tell him about your belts.
Okay. I am a five-time champion, one MMA championship. I have four Muay Thai championships. I won in the past 3-4 years. I'm the best fighter in Arizona in my weight and class. I'm super, super happy about that and proud. And I own a gym called Dragon Snake MMA and Fitness, where my fighters are also champions. I train state, national, and world champions on an amateur and professional level. If you'd like to come out, you should come out to my gym. It's in Tempe, Dragon Snake MMA, dragonsnakemma.com. Check it out. And that's what I do in my life. I've dedicated my entire life to the martial arts.
Yes, he has. And I am your host, M'Jaie Mangus. And that's really as far as I've got with this, you guys. Seriously, this is like going to be completely organic. And we'll be setting the bar for all the future segments. And so far, we're drinking, and that might be...
Cheers.
Yes. It's 5 o'clock somewhere, but it's 2 o'clock in Tempe on a Sunday.
That's right.
Okay, so, but it's going to be awesome. You guys, I picked you for a reason. Okay, so first question. If you could be a celebrity, who would it be? Who and why? For a day. Okay, I'll jump in there. Mine would be Mariah Carey, because she truly is the epitome of a diva to me. And I would just love to be able to act out. I would love to be able to sing like that, first of all.
I think mine would be Rihanna.
Rihanna? Okay.
Yeah.
Why?
I think she like travels all these great places, and I just like the way that she carries herself.
Yeah? What she stands for?
Yeah, she's like a badass.
She's a badass. Have you watched her show.
No. What is it?
It's, I forget the name of it. I forget the name of it. I'll get that to you. Who would you be? Who would you be?
Still thinking this one through.
Yeah, me too. That's a good one.
Yeah.
You know, I've never really thought about who I would want to be for a day, but I've thought about who I would want to have a lunch with. Mm-hmm. If I had three celebrity people to join me, and it would always be somebody funny. So I always thought Steve Buscemi was a funny character in movies. I would pick him.
I don't know who that is.
I would pick him. he's been in a lot of Adam Sandler movies. He's been in Con Air. He's the kind of the psycho in Con Air. Okay. And then maybe somebody like The Rock, which I used
like
to go.
Too.
I used to
The Rock. He's married.
We used to go to the UFC fights and the WWE fights, and we would sit ringside when The Rock was The Rock.
Okay.
And I just thought, what a loud, crazy, fun personality he had. And I think he would just be an interesting person to kind of sit. So him, Steve Buscemi, we'll look him up in a minute so everyone knows who we're talking about.
But there's nobody you would want to be for a day?
You know, it would probably be somebody in a high-powered business, like a CEO of like a big company, just to kind of be on that side and maybe learn a little bit about what these, you know, big companies are doing out there.
That's
so
fascinating.
Something business, cool. Yeah, because I feel like I could learn from that.
And you?
And me. I if I was to be anyone for a day, I would have to say Mike Tyson.
Oh, okay.
I really would love to be inside of his brain and see how it functions and how his thought processes and what direction his brain goes when it comes to different subjects and daily things and just mundane stuff that happens throughout the day, because I feel like we're a lot alike. He's a really sensitive person. Mm-hmm. He cries a lot in interviews and things like that, but he's an absolute murderer. Like he will like put you down in 10 seconds. He like killed most of
as the ambulance drives by.
The universe delivers. So he's like, he's so far on each side of the spectrum to where he's an absolute murderer, but he's also very sensitive and soft. And
he's super wise. Anytime I see him coming across my Instagram, I stop and listen, because he is so down to earth and so real. Mm-hmm. And yeah, that would be awesome.
I feel like we relate to it. I would love to be in his brain.
So that would be like Mariah Carey and Mike Tyson going out on a date today.
Nice. Except the only thing that I hate there is me looking up at her.
Oh, that's funny. Only 5'8". That's okay. Okay. All right. So this is a question. Brittany, you've never been married, but
well,
should good. Oh, that's right. There was that one time. And I married you.
Yeah, you did, actually.
Married for a hot minute.
I am a minister, in case you guys didn't know that. And I am for hire. You can hire me to marry you.
Did marry me.
Melanie's a minister, too. I did marry you.
Sister ministers.
That's crazy.
That's cool.
I forgot about that. Okay, so this does apply. But so should looks fade before you marry somebody? Really, so dead quiet.
Here's the thing.
I really like
you'd
this
have
question.
To be with somebody for a really long time for those looks to fade.
Well, looks so can fade in a year because of somebody's personality.
Yeah.
But I like this question because it's like we can be attracted and put up with things that we normally, because there's this physical attraction. But if we didn't have that, then we really got down to the person, who they really were. How they behave, that kind of thing, if that would change, if you would really marry them. What do you think? How much do looks really play?
People can have some very attractive qualities that aren't their looks. So sometimes some of those qualities can be even more attractive than their physical being.
Absolutely. Because looks do fade, right? Mm-hmm. And then what you are there for is
the soul.
Hopefully the, yeah. I mean, if you're in the right marriage. Right.
Absolutely.
Yes. So looks can fade, should fade.
We have no choice but to
They're going to be fading. Let's face it.
They're definitely fading.
Have an
expiration date. Oh, God. If you love what you do, but were offered to get paid 10 times as much doing something it is that you hate, would you do it?
Wow, that is...
Good,
that was a good question.
I wouldn't do it either.
Yeah, yeah. My happiness is so much more important than any amount of money you could ever give me.
Right.
Or I could ever have. It's like, no.
I agree.
If I still got to make my own schedule, then maybe. I have to be able to make my own schedule.
How long do I have to do the crappy thing?
I think there's still going to be a balance.
Year.
You got to be balanced, a work-life balance. And if you give that up and you give up what you're passionate about, then it's not worth it. So
yeah, I
could. Someone says,
it.
I'll give you $10 million to leave and do this. If I don't feel it, I don't think it's worth it.
No, I can't do anything that I'm not passionate about.
No.
Period. So, I mean, I could make money doing money than I make now than doing something else. Absolutely.
Yeah.
We all could, but we don't. Brittney, you mentioned this the other day when you were here about a situationship and a textationship. Have you guys heard about this?
No, I'm fascinated.
We know what entanglement is, but we were talking about relationships and people being in something complicated or whatever, and she said, is it a textationship?
Yeah, one of my teenager clients are talking about how, like,
this is a teenager thing.
But it's like carrying into
absolutely.
Like adults.
No, absolutely, because it's a real thing. That's what I want to talk about.
Yeah, like the kids, like they'll text each other, but then they won't actually go meet up in person. Really, like they just have this like emotional connection over text, and so they call it their little like textationship. And then once they've actually met up, but they're not like committed to each other, it's a situationship.
A situationship. So that's kind of like, it's kind of like it's complicated. Huh. Well, it's complicated kind of implies that it's a little bit drama or something like that.
Mm-hmm.
But the textation in...
But then I think people are doing that with like those dating apps or like Instagram where you're just having these ongoing conversations with people that you don't know.
Yeah. So there should be like a DM ship.
Yeah, yeah,
things like that. So Facebook should.
What is this though? You are saving yourself a
Facebook Messenger
ship, maybe.
Yeah,
you create this sort of space, the safe space for yourself, where you can be whoever, do whatever you want through a text. But then
it's a false sense of security.
Honestly, I wonder how it continues once you do meet up.
Well, because I think a lot of teens, probably 20-year-olds probably are having problems socializing with the opposite sex.
We because live through our now phones now.
Yeah, we live through our phones. Mm-hmm. So I thought that was really funny. Okay, would you date yourself? Why or why not?
Hell no. Nope to the no.
I wouldn't date me either. I would be like, that's way too fucking complicated over there. All that is way too complicated. Or I don't think that I would be able to get away with shit with me. Is that true?
I would have to agree with that.
Would you date you or what?
Yeah, why, absolutely.
And you would, why? She's like, I'm a fucking cat. Badass. Like you said.
Yeah. No shit.
And Brittney?
I would definitely date myself.
You would?
Yeah, because then I would understand myself already. I'm really difficult to understand, so we'd already have that going on. And I'm real spontaneous, never get boring. Yeah, it'd be great.
Love it.
That's what I think would be my downfall.
The fights might be
really
toxic.
I would be too much alike with myself. The fights would be insane.
Yeah.
And it would go on for weeks and weeks.
That's true.
A slightly toxic element.
Good point.
Oh, God, that's funny. Okay, would you want to live forever? I know Ricky would.
I would.
I think that that would be a horrible
live
thing.
Forever and live age forever. Or like
age
later.
I wouldn't want to live forever and be the perfect age. I would not want to live forever. I think that's no.
but living forever with, I mean, think about it. You get to, does everyone else live forever with you?
No.
That's a good question, because
I don't think so.
Then I get to go on endless journeys and adventures with the people that come across my path, which is like really the freaking heart of my whole entire life. And living is just like sharing this earth and the world with everyone that I come across. And if I can do that forever, why not?
He doesn't want to die. He's one of those people that do not want to die.
I hate the idea of dying.
He's going to have to listen to that book.
What?
Many Lives, Many Masters. Yeah.
I think it'll knock your fear.
Yeah.
It cured me of that fear. And I would say, no, I don't want to live forever. I think
the fear part, because I know what my fear is. What would be your fear?
My fear now is leaving my kids behind because they're still young, and the worry about them being okay. I think if they were older and they're established, I don't have to worry about them. I know they're going to be fine. But at just a young age, I would be sad for them and I would worry about that. I feel like I like the idea of having many adventures, but I think my heart would break every time that person would die. And I would come in contact mm-hmm. with all these wonderful people I would build situationships with and relationships. But then having to see the people I love die, and I would be tortured by that.
That's very funny. My Uncle Rudy used to say a joke. He would always say, I'm going to live forever, guys, because he's a really huge into working out and martial arts and fitness. He'd be like, I'm going to live longer than everybody. Only thing that sucks about that is that I have to watch everyone die. Yeah. He would laugh when he would say that. And maybe I picked up a little bit off of my Uncle Rudy for the living part, but I don't want to leave. It's really, that's my main fear.
You're having too much fun.
I believe we get to do it again. So
I don't want to leave everyone. I love you guys all so much. Like, I don't want to go and take off. I want to continue doing awesome stuff forever.
I want to come back better, stronger, faster. Okay. Is life easy when you're good looking?
It sure is a little bit easier, I would say.
I don't think it is. I don't think that it is. I think that, you get the benefit of a lot of things. But then also the other side, I think that it's hard on attractive people.
Mm-hmm. I think there's a little bit of both, too.
Mm-hmm.
I think there's a lot more people like the types that maybe aren't good for you, that like cling to you, that you have to navigate through all of that. Like, people want to take advantage
mm-hmm.
or like utilize you or objectify you or hate on you, a lot of that.
I don't think that you're real.
But you can
feel feelings.
But we can also resource very well.
Yes, no, absolutely.
You learn how to carve your path.
I think with good looks comes judgment from other people.
Absolutely.
You are being judged
absolutely
immediately.
Mm-hmm.
Why does she look that good?
Mm-hmm.
What's going on behind mm-hmm. the scenes? So mm-hmm. it can be, a double-edged sword, really.
Intimidated by beautiful things.
Absolutely, mm-hmm. yeah.
It's like also to upkeep it.
Or it's like that inspiration that turns into envy mm-hmm. very quickly.
Yep. Absolutely.
I always say that when I die and come back, I want to be like that cat lady that lives in an apartment and just watches TV and comes home and eats popcorn.
Not a hot cat lady.
Oh. Just somebody that doesn't have to give a fuck. Like, that is their payoff. They must have done something in another lifetime that they got to enjoy a life where they didn't have those types of pressures. We sign up for it ourselves when we try and do things to make ourselves more attractive, et cetera, yeah. whatever, if we're naturally mm-hmm. attractive. Again, that's,
Well, it comes with expectations.
Yeah.
Right? So people expect things of you because of the way you look.
You're
and
a target.
Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm. But the cat lady, she just gets to come home and watch TV, and she probably goes into work and clocks in. And I just think that would be like a very easy, relaxing kind of life.
Satisfying.
I don't know why. Yeah. I don't know why I couldn't do it in this lifetime, but I think in another lifetime that would be cool. All right. pizza more delicious than hamburgers?
Pizza all the way.
That's a tough one.
I like a pizza on a burger.
Pizza burgers. My dad makes these things called pizza burgers.
And, I've had them.
And they're actually really good. It's like a hybrid of a pizza. Amazing.
It's pretty good. It's pretty good.
He mixes hamburger and spaghetti sauce and puts them on hamburger buns, but he melts mozzarella and pepperoni on it.
Like it's a sloppy Joe cheese.
Almost. It's like, kind of. It's with mozzarella and pepperoni on it, and it's actually weird and good.
Okay.
Oh, that's funny. I don't know. Yeah. I think I'm going to go pizza too. So pizza?
Pizza.
All right. Do you believe in aliens?
Yes, absolutely.
Absolutely.
I believe in aliens.
There's no way we're in this vast, unending universe with all of the suns, because our if you don't know, the sun is a star, and all of the stars in the universe, there has to be planets revolving around one, at least one of those millions of stars that is just the right distance away from it to promote life.
Uh-huh. Do you think they're like little green aliens, or do you think they're like little sound thingies?
That's what I'm not sure about. I think it's probably more of a flesh. You know, I mean, if it's alive, it has to have systems that keep it alive and it. So I don't think they're green, weird looking. They could be, but I'm guessing maybe they're probably more.
Why are they depicted like that? Why are they depicted like that? Then people that, you know, we've seen
sci-fi.
These.
Well,
yeah, you know, these alien people that have actually seen say that they've been abducted.
If you come to Earth, you would see tigers and lions and giraffes and humans and so I mean, they're probably a vast majority of living things on other planets that would promote life, not just one.
So what is
you know what I mean?
Yeah,
like plants are living, like maybe like plants.
I know, but they depict aliens with big eyes and big heads and little chin. You know, like that has to come from somewhere.
Maybe someone had a dream about it.
That's a great question.
Where the movies and all of that. So and when people have had these experiences, I mean, some of it's really convincing. You watch these documentaries and you're like, oh my god. Abducted and they come back with these memories of or maybe that's just what being implanted into their mind to come back and say that that's what they look like. You know, all right, this is a good question for you, Ricky. Would a gorilla win over a fight with a bear, or would
a gorilla would win? It's more athletic. Bears, their arms are short. It's not. Gorillas are made for athleticism. They have long arms. They could grab, jump, throw. Like, they're much more athletic, so I would have to go with the gorilla.
That's a good way of looking at it.
Aren't they smarter, too?
I believe so.
They have to be.
Yeah. They're more human-like. I think about it. I mean, they look more like us than a bear, right? They're more characteristics.
A human beat a bear?
A human would not win a fight with a bear. A human would lose a fight with a bear. Do not fight a bear.
Could you beat a bear? Could you
will lose.
How about you, though?
Me? No, I will lose. If I fight a bear, I will lose. There's no winning that fight.
Yeah. No, just run. That's funny. Yeah. Get away.
That's funny. All right. Do you pee in the shower?
Definitely.
Doesn't everyone?
I think this is what everybody lies about. They may say that they don't. I heard this on a radio station question. Somebody called in and there was this guy that had called in and said that he had like a one night stand with this girl and she they jumped in the shower the next morning and all of a sudden, he looked down and she was peeing in his shower.
With him in it.
And he was like, ew, like, I don't even know you. This is like way too fast or whatever. But so I thought that was an interesting question because I think it's one of those things that people lie about.
I'd pee by myself in the shower. I don't know. I'd be like, hey, guy, I just met you, but I'm just like, right, you're peeing.
Right.
Peeing on other people is a whole nother level.
It's a different fetish.
You
pee
on me.
It gives a whole new meaning to golden shower. Oh, that's so funny.
But you're not going to, like, get out and then almost slip off the toilet seat and go.
To the bathroom. And you go to the bathroom before you get in the shower. I would think that. But if something
happens. Sometimes the water in the shower makes you have to go.
Oh, yeah, because it's all warm. And okay, if you could have one superpower, what would it be? I would be invisible. I always say that.
That's a great one. I love that. Invisible cloak idea. That's amazing.
I think that would be amazing.
That's great.
I kind of feel like I've, you know, as a child, I always felt invisible. So I think that's probably why that resonates with me a little bit.
If I had a superpower, I would want it to be the ability to read other people's minds and their thoughts and what they're thinking.
Oh, shit. That's pretty...
That would be what I would want.
Wow.
Because then
I don't know if I would want to know what everybody was thinking.
We're hanging out and you're acting cool to me, but you're really thinking some other shit. I need to know that. So,
yeah. And then if they knew that you had that superpower, they would, you know, they would be trying to think of, like, I don't know, pizza or hamburger. Pizza or hamburger. Trying to keep their mind off of it.
I like both of those. I think I would want to be able to fly like Superman. Okay. Honestly.
All right. Mm-hmm.
All right. I feel like I've done that in my dreams. I can fly in my dreams. So I think that would be kind of fun.
Oh, wow.
I was actually just going to say fly. Either being able to fly or kind of like a human lie detector test. Like, I would like to just kind of know.
Shit, yeah.
I don't really want to know what someone's thinking.
You would like to know a radar. We go lying. Yeah. Oh, that is,
I don't want to know their thoughts, but you're, I want to know if it's like,
yeah.
Wow. Here's a lying asshole.
Yeah, that's great.
I think you guys have a little bit of that already, though.
We do.
Yeah, but
that's,
we need it.
Intuition.
Yeah.
Like,
I need
100%. She's like, I want to pronounce. Yeah. Kind of like a human, like a, you know, low Carfax,
like
every human I interact with.
Oh, shit.
That'd be nice. Yeah. I mean, we should start looking people up, actually. Mm-hmm. Are clowns scary? I love clowns. They inspire me. But there are so many people that think that clowns are scary, and I don't.
They're creepy a little bit, I gotta be honest. Only because of the representation of them in scary
horror films.
They flipped my brain. It's too late now. I already see them.
So that's what happened. But in your childhood, they were like.
One of the most famous serial killers, John Wayne Gacy. Was an actual clown as a job in his life, and murdered young
boys.
And they found like 30. They found like 30 something teenage young bodies.
I've never heard of that.
Buried under his house.
Yep, mm-hmm. He showed up painted like a clown.
He was actually a clown for a career. That was one of his careers.
Which is why
in my brain put that there.
Well, if I liked clowns, I don't know.
How long ago was that? No, I actually literally collect clowns.
That was like early
clowns.
70s.
I do. I have a whole thing in the garage.
It was like early
clowns.
70s when he did that.
I mean, I think, you know, Barnum and Bailey's circus clowns can be funny because they're with their props and their jokes and stuff. But I'm with Ricky on this. I think the film industry has taken clown to a whole nother scary level.
I wonder when that started, though. And would that be based off of that story? If that's when it kind of turned...
Maybe I'm sure
scary movies.
I'm sure it did. And I once I once had a clown. I had a clown for my son Mondo's like 4th birthday. Had a clown come, and it was really creepy. It bothered me because it was a grown ass man.
He's like,
I'm
like,
I swear it was a grown ass man acting not like he should be acting. Like, he was acting like a kid and then saying things like a child. And I was like, it was like really bothered me for some reason. It was like so inauthentic. Like it just, like, I don't know, something inside of me, like some little alarm inside me. It's like, this is not real. This is not cool. This is not okay. This guy's not acting like a man. And he's just playing with little kids. Yes, yes. And it made me feel really awkward.
I just remembered I did a piece on mental illness, and I was a clown, painted as a clown, and I haven't released that yet. But the inspiration behind it was how the makeup, you know,
transforms you.
It doesn't transform you, but you can hide behind it.
Okay.
And so clowns typically, to me, when you meet them in person, they don't seem like they are the really genuinely happy person behind the makeup, and they create this and they go out and they do. And I think that's a lot to do with, I mean, just people in general have to put on a different face every day when they go out, and who they really are, what they're really feeling.
They're hiding behind them.
And I just use the clown for that picture to represent that. But I love clowns. I painted this painting of a clown. And so I redid this because that's why I painted that picture specifically. And then redid it for mental illness. So I have to release that. I didn't think about that till right now. What favorite Netflix series? What's your favorite so far since the pandemic? Everything. I've never watched that much TV since.
I've got a couple.
I had to be one.
Oh, God. Well, the one I'm watching right now, which I can't get enough of, is called Ozark.
We just finished that. It was really
MG. Yes, I'm in so season good. 3 right now.
So good.
Just on like the 10th episode. And just when you think like, okay, I can kind of see where this is going. Bam, it changes direction like in a blink, and I'm just floored.
Did you finish it yet?
No, just I'm on season 3.
Oh my God.
Yes,
We binge watched that. Yeah,
like,
baby.
And everyone's
I'm sitting on the edge of my seat right now.
What episode are you? What episode? Because they're like, oh, some good stuff's about to happen. I'm like,
every episode.
Good stuff happens in every episode. And now I figured out, finally, too late, that the O with the four things is like a foreshadowed, like there's some
it's
things
called Easter
happen.
Eggs. They're called Easter eggs. And you find them in the episode.
I love
the
it.
The four things, I was doing it every show.
With John, I was like, okay, keys,
find
cigarettes,
airplane,
and something else, right? And then you pay attention.
They're called Easter eggs, and you find them through the show. Like, so awesome.
That's my pick for Netflix right now.
I'm glad you caught that. Your brain works really awesomely if you caught that.
don't spoil it for me, though. I'm gonna leave here today and go watch a couple more episodes.
Oh my God, you're gonna be sitting on the edge of your seat when it's over. You're gonna be like, I hate that this is over right now. I need more. I need more.
But I'm glad that they're ending it and they're not dragging it out. Like, right. What was that one?
Breaking
Bad.
Oh my God, that was good. But then it just got.
I didn't
see went on and 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 on. You're like, oh my God, it's still going. I think. I don't know.
That's a good one.
What about you?
I haven't really watched a lot of series. I almost started Ozark. I think the last one I watched was You, and that was pretty crazy. Mm-hmm. That was good.
It was really good.
Yeah. I started to stay caught up on that one.
I keep a list in my phone, and I'm just sort of like working down my list.
I think my favorite, most memorable, and craziest one is Tiger King. I don't know why that stuck with me. That was the craziest show ever.
I've not seen it.
You have not seen Tiger King.
No.
You're the only person on the planet that has not seen Tiger King.
Probably.
Oh my God, Mel, you've got to watch that.
Yes.
Yeah.
Has John's not seen it either?
No.
Hi, John.
Oh, wow.
Shout out to John.
you guys have Tiger King soon, John.
That is so cool. Okay, so then you guys get on. Do you think that she really fed her ex-husband to the tiger?
Oh my God.
I think she did. I think she did.
There's something about her energy and aura that makes me feel no bueno.
I know.
What, they never found him again?
No.
There's just nothing that
she benefited a lot of money. She
the actual Tiger King is in jail.
Yeah,
the main guy.
Yes, the main guy's in prison right now for attempting to have her murdered.
Yeah, because she was driving him crazy because they had this
feud
between each other. And it is a trippy story. And again, when things are directed by Hollywood, they're going to sway one side or the other. So there could be more about it that, but watching Tiger King, I left with the impression that
they gotta make it a good show. So they plant that seed in your mind, like maybe she did, maybe she didn't, but we're gonna show you everything that points to she did.
Yeah. So it was one, it could have been one side, but I had to been like, there couldn't have been, unbiased.
There's no doubt she did it.
I totally agree. But there's a Tiger King 2. So you know even what we're talking about, even though you didn't watch it.
Yeah, no. A girlfriend of mine's aunt was married to one of the characters of Tiger King. Wow. Like when she was a little girl. So she actually, her picture, her family photos appear in the show. So we've talked about
Wow. Okay.
And we're like,
the inside.
We're like, what? you like family with these people? But that was a long time ago. So yeah, I do know sort of bits and pieces.
There's so many layers to the story as well with all the characters and everyone around. It's amazing.
It is crazy. There's a second one though, and I've not really been drawn for some reason. Because once you watch something the original and then they kind of do another take on it, it's just gonna the same.
It's going to be draggy.
Right. Something about it. Okay. So sock, shoe, or sock, shoe.
What?
What are you?
Socks, then shoes.
So you're a sock, shoe?
Yep.
I'm a sock, shoe. Sock, shoe. Okay.
I don't even know what we're talking about.
He's like, I wear flip flops.
I don't wear the socks.
So when you put your socks on, socks and shoes, do you go sock, then shoe, or do you do sock, shoe?
Oco blende.
When you
like,
put
do you
your
do
socks,
both your socks
do you put socks on first, and then you put your shoes on,
I totally
or do you do
one foot,
sock, and then your shoe, and then go to the other foot, and
totally,
do sock,
totally,
and then
totally.
Shoe?
Sock, shoe.
What? Baby, I'm a sock, shoe.
Are you?
No, I'm a sock, shoe. What did you say you were?
I put both socks on, then both shoes.
Oh,
it's
my
like
God. Really? Okay.
Yeah.
So they say majority of people out there are sock, shoe. But they say the sock, shoe is the better lover.
Wow.
I just really got out of it. I'm saying that's what it means. No. No, but there is this thing that they talk about that. And majority of people do the sock, shoe. And they say that it means, said to mean that person is more organized and maybe more compassionate. But I think if you do the sock, shoe, you just follow everything through.
Mm.
Nobody's ever thought about that, huh? You're talking about sock, shoe.
Yeah.
It means something about your personality.
Yeah, no doubt.
Or if you have like the sensory thing where you can't have one foot that's cold on the floor and the other foot with a sock.
I just feel completed to put both socks on.
Yeah, me too.
In
yeah.
one moment.
Yeah,
like,
yeah,
both socks
sure.
on.
I literally,
what if you have to go and like get something from another room? You don't want one sock on a foot and then
one
naked foot.
Exactly. I was a sock, shoe. And then when that topic came up and I heard about it and I paid attention to it, I was like, I'm going to see what it feels like to put on sock, shoe. I've done sock, shoe ever since then. Okay, so let me find my phone. I messaged you guys. So another thing I've always wanted to do was a Dear M. And that's where people can write in for life or love advice. I'll give my professional advice as a power coach. And you guys get to give your girlfriend, homie, whatever advice that you would give, which are typically totally different.
Okay. Sure.
Okay.
We'll see how we match up with your professional advice.
No, I want you guys to literally, because
what is it? Well, wait a minute.
See how far off we are.
Am I close to you? We're really far.
Well, when I'm talking to a friend, I'll say, "Do you want my power coach advice, or do you want my girlfriend advice?" Because it's always different. You know, it really is, and then they get to pick. Anyway, so here we've got Dear M, I am brokenhearted and could use some getting over a man who recently broke up with me. It was only 3 months, but the best sex I've ever had. I could see red flags, but chose to ignore them. For example, still being in touch with his old girlfriends. I figured if I sat back and made no demands, he might come around. It seemed to be working. Then he entirely stopped texting. Within a week, communication dwindled to just good night. I knew he was going for a woman that we mutually know. Not them. They know, not me. I'm sick to my stomach and want to move on. Advice. So when I read this, I was like, okay, so first of all, two people can't have sex just because somebody's good, then it's great. It takes two people. to have really good sex. Mm-hmm. You can be really good in bed and have sex with somebody who sucks, and then it just fucking sucks. You know, it's not good. So I think that you should credit yourself and know that you were very much a part of that, because this is all about you. We don't want to give him too much power, because you hold all the power inside of yourself. So you're just looking at it like he provided this, but you were part of that. So maybe there was something about him that allowed you to open yourself up more, that personality or something that allowed you to be and do things that you would have never done because you were mixed up with the wrong partners to begin with, that you've had sex with, that you couldn't be as, you know, whatever, free with. So that could be it. So again, that is you. You were a part of that. But I'm seeing the red flags here, and this is what everybody does, or majority of people do. They start lowering their standards. They start seeing flags and they go, I'm going to ignore that. People typically do this because they're afraid love is not going to come back by. Maybe they can get over it. They'll look the other way, but they start lowering their standards. And this is where we get caught up in relationships, situationships, entanglement, and all that stuff, where in the end, you know, we're really not happy. So the sex, I believe, this good sex that she's talking about, would have started going bad, because I think majority of women are connected emotionally. So she starts feeling like she's let down and she's lowering her standards and she's hurting, then the sex is going to start getting, she's not going to be as open. Mm-hmm. Does that make sense? Mm-hmm. So I think that you lowered your standards, and if you would have honored them, then you might have had a couple of good roll around in the hay with him, but you would have, you can't lower your standards. This is where manipulation actually comes in, mm-hmm. where we start trying to manipulate a situation, and then we get back manipulation, or we're upfront with ourselves. We don't have to be upfront with them. We're like, look, this dude's doing this and this and this and this and this is just not cool with me, and I'm going to end this. And then you honor yourself and you move on. You get to find somebody else. But my advice would be to do a lot of self-love. Know that you are part of that good sex, and now you can go out with the next person and rock their fucking world. And you don't lower your standards, and that people come into your life to teach us, you know, stuff about ourselves. And you don't give this person the power. You've got to look at how much you contributed to this, both good and bad, and be like, okay. And walk away thinking that you're good in bed too. Because there has to be something there. You can't have two people, you know what I mean?
Right. No, I agree.
So what's your guys's advice?
I'm going to say, so just from what she has explained, going into it, she already knew there wasn't going to be long term, because there were still conversations happening with exes and others. So really, she should have known that it was just for the sex. But I think maybe she was hoping for an emotional connection, and that wasn't reciprocated. So I agree. I think time to move on and find someone else who you connect with both physically, emotionally, mentally, spiritually. That whole, it all has to be there.
Right. You can have not just one box.
No. Right. She checked the good sex box, right, for sure. Mm-hmm. And hey, yeah, who doesn't love that? I mean, come on. Mm-hmm. But he wasn't emotionally unavailable to her, and all these other things are happening, and she is lowering her standards to say, okay, maybe just the good sex is the only box I should be worried about. No,
but
she
also the keeping up with the ex is a sign of insecurity of somebody who can, is not strong enough to fucking move on. Nope. And be in their own shit, and it's weak. So if she just looks at it differently, she'll go, that was a weak motherfucker.
And, you know, and it's hard for her.
I was weak, and that actually turns me on, and or turns me off. Not on. And so it shifts the power, the energy shifts completely
and then you don't feel bad about the relationship. Baby, hold on. Do you remember that meme that we read from that website? Somebody that you follow. I follow, but he's not always on my feed. He was saying, "Will somebody fuck me good already so I can
get over
my ex?" Somebody fuck me good so that I can get over my ex. I thought that was funny.
That almost gives me a reason to what I was going to say. I feel like we have to check ourselves sometimes and remind ourselves that humans are creatures of habit and we don't like change. And I think that's what keeps us continuing or wanting to continue things sometimes in life, when we have to think outside the box and go, okay, this is probably a huge lesson for me. This is for my growth. This is for the more evolved me to happen. This is for so many other reasons. And we have to accept that it's over. And just be strong in that and find your strength in that and go, okay, I'm okay with that. This is over. It's okay. I'm going to grow from this. I'm going to become a better me for this. And let go.
That is totally accurate, because acceptance is the one thing that keeps us from our happiness. When we resist and we don't want to accept, if we could just accept our situation, now we can move forward. Acceptance brings us joy and growth. She's not wanting to accept. She's not wanting something. It's like, it's just the sex. There's other people out there but it is hard to find really good sex. But that is not a reason. But,
I mean, I think kind of like you guys said, I guess just spinning off of what you guys said, like just kind of, you got to fix your crown, girl, take your dignity and move on. Like,
keep your dignity.
You know, you guys are connected sexually and that's great, but you're going to connect with a lot of other people sexually and that's not so hard to find. But being compatible with somebody, it sounds like you tried to define that after the fact, and when you found out,
good point,
there were all these red flags, now it's upsetting you, so he's not looking to change it, or he would have already, you know, put the effort in there, so you gotta just go.
All right, you guys give good advice. You guys could be coaches. All right, everybody. If you would like to be on MN Friends, just email loveandliespodcast@gmail.com. And if you would like to send in anonymous questions for the Dear M section to get the free advice, just also email loveandliespodcast@gmail.com. All right, guys. We get to go back out into the community and do all the things that it is that we love to do.
Yeah.
And inspire and serve others and live our life. And I really appreciate this time with you guys. Did you enjoy it? Any feedback?
Absolutely.
I had the best time.
I love all of us putting our brains together and sharing all of our thoughts on topics, because then I get to walk away a little more wise and intelligent, and with more tools in my bag than I did when I walked in. So I really appreciate it being here.
And I thank you guys so much for playing. This is like a play box for me, and I know, or sandbox, play box, same thing. But I know I do lots of, I am always coming up with something. So I appreciate you guys playing with me. Now, how can everybody get to follow you, find you? Go ahead.
My Instagram is Brittney Dawn Fitz,
Brittney
Dawn Fitz.
Dawn Fit. And that's her Instagram. She's got lots and lots of followers. Go ahead, baby.
My Instagram and Facebook is Dragon Snake MMA. You can find me at both handles on both platforms, as well as DragonSnakeMMA.com. Ricardo Jimenez is my actual name, and my personal pages are Ricardo Jimenez Jr. Follow me. Let's reciprocate and move forward.
All right. Mel, I actually had to look mine up
because you're something rebel.
Complicated over here. Yeah, mine is Miss Rebel MD. So Miss MISS _ Rebel REBEL _MD.
All right. And I am all social media, M'Jaie Mangus. And Love and Lies podcast. You can find us on all of the major platforms. If you guys want to send in any questions for us to include in our debate, again, just email loveandliespodcast@gmail.com, and that's it.
Oh, wait, one more thing. Thank you guys for having me as the male guest. Super honored to be the male guest today, guys. You guys will be here, but you're going to
hear don't be different. Everybody will always be different.
Okay. I appreciate being here. Thank you.
Oh, maybe I had to have you, obviously, but this is so cool. And I pictured this first time with you guys and
the kickoff episode.
Yeah, I know. Are you guys feeling good after your drinks?
Yeah, slightly wine drunk.
Brittany's got a birthday coming up.
Yeah,
wish you happy birthday on social media.
30-30.
Oh my god, there we go. Going out to dinner Thursday night.
Yeah, y'all are coming.
Let's go.
All right, you guys. All right, that's it. Much love.